Herkese merhaba. Hello everyone. I am Bahadur and I will present our research on deep neuromorphic controller with dynamic topology for area robots. This illustration represents our vision where we would like to handle real challenges for different tasks, including monitoring, first responder deployment, interaction with environment, and area repair operation for our infrastructures. In this project, we studied the adaptation and learning model to capture different tasks. For example, this illustration shows that we have an initial trajectory in pre-flight as a first task, and an aerodynamic interaction phase for an inspection task, and the landing as a last task. The question here we are focusing is based on how can we develop an approach that can be flexible to capture the new type of data stream in the form of disturbance, changes in the dynamics, and the noises on the inputs or the outputs. We are addressing the following challenges. The first one, we would like to have capability to adapt to different tasks without retraining phase from scratch. At the same time, we would like to provide stability while learning the new conditions. In this context, our contributions are twofold. First, we are proposing an adaptive learning law that we developed for self-evolving deep neural networks, and we proposed our real-time evaluations on area robots. We can take a look at some animals and their behavior for different tasks. For example, the dung beetle is known to be collecting animal wastes and transport them for different purposes. These particles could be small, like the ones on the left side, or they could be big, like the ones on the right side. For example, this ball is a lot bigger as compared to its body, but they are quite successful in rolling them. More interestingly, they could do the same task even in the night, where this work is studied. Their behavior and patterns for the visual cues. If we look at this amazing animal's brain, we can see that there are different regions activated with different tasks. We can infer that the learning process is rather flexible as compared to the approaches that are available in the literature for our robots. After the inspiration from nature, we can formalize our framework. For a simple interactive task, we need to also consider additional challenges starting from variations in the mass distribution, contact phase with the surface, the stiffness of the system, dynamically feasible trajectories, constraints for the application such as limited working space, aerodynamic effects like ceiling effect, unknown characteristics of the surface for an interaction task, sliding on the surface, and maintaining a certain force range. We can take a look at these two examples. This video shows that the system could not handle the ceiling forces that ended up with a crash. And the second video shows that limited workspace and contact with an impact can lead to unfortunate crashes too. Within this context, we can focus on the following research questions. The first, can we design an approach that can handle different tasks without crashing the system? Can such an approach satisfy the onboard computation limits? How to design a flexible learning scheme, and how to stabilize the system with a flexible learning framework? And what is available in the literature? We are looking at our basic generalized feedback control diagram. We have dynamics at the core, which could be complex, nonlinear, high dimensional. The dynamics could change in time if we consider adaptive morphologies in design, environmental changes, or fault conditions like loss of motor. At the same time, there are disturbances like wind gust or an unmeasurable effects that change the dynamics. We have high level objective function we would like to optimize. The main idea here is to drive a control law based on sensor measurements of the system that can drive the system through actuation. The question we have is, what can we use to handle various tasks while we address the associated challenges? Let's first take a look at model-based control approach, which is model predictive control. And we know that it is suitable for linear and nonlinear systems, but it requires precise model and identification. Noise and disturbances can affect the performance, and it requires tuning process for the application. Let's also consider the learning-based controllers. We know that they are also suitable for nonlinear systems, but the data collection and data creating needs some effort. Similarly, noise and disturbances can affect the performance. We also know that better performance can be achieved with a very deep structure, but it comes with a cost on the computation time. When we look at the learning literature, we can see that most of the deep learning approaches are mostly considering single task learning and the data is processed and structured. For the updated data and neural network model, they are assumed as static. This leads to the problems such as concept drift if the streaming data structure is different than what is trained. Another problem is about how to embrace the new data and how to rely on the past data in the problem at hand. What we need is having a learning that can start from scratch with an online data stream. We would like to have adaptation to build the neural network model, and we would like to leverage a reasonable adaptation speed, and we would like to have a reasonable tuning time. Within this framework, we would like to address all these items within deep neuromorphic controller that we are proposing. This is our proposed approach, which is working together with the baseline controller. The baseline controller in our case is sliding mode control, and we would like to train our network with the inputs computed by the controller. Since it's a data stream based approach, we need to evaluate how far we are away from the ground truth. In our problem, this corresponds to the tracking error. The proposed approach consists of expandable hidden layers and adjustable nodes, and a linear single output layer. Tan edge activation function is selected for each node of the hidden layer that keep the output between -1 and 1. The output of the network is the control signal for the dedicated axis. For the adaptation, we are evaluating the bias and the variance for certain time windows. We need to have variable capacity configuration and layer expansion mechanism to achieve adaptive topologies, and the details will be given in the next slides. We are looking at the starting configuration at the top left. This step is performed with the bias variance decomposition technique, where high bias stands for the underfitting condition that we are aiming to handle by adding new nodes. On the other hand, high variance characterizes the overfitting condition, and our approach is targeting to remove inactive nodes to tackle with this case. The node growing strategy is based on the high bias condition identified by modified statistical process control approach. This method is commonly found in anomaly detection problems, and it's applied here to identify the high bias condition. The condition is based on bias and variance bounds. The main difference in our case is including a sigma rule based confidence levels. The use of this confidence level allows a flexible approach where the node growing strategy can occur frequently or sparsely depending on the user choice. The node removing is triggered if high variance condition is satisfied, also depending on our confidence level. The node is pruned with the lowest node contribution that we calculated with the L2 norm of its consecutive weights. The layer expansion strategy is governed by the concept drift detection method, identifying the significant change in the data stream. It's an indication of a heavy shift either in dynamics, environmental changes, or a new task. This implies that the existing model capacity has to be expanded to accommodate the new concept. The addition of a new layer is called for because it is capable of enhancing the model capacity significantly as compared to addition of new nodes. This method is performed by first finding the gradient mean bias over preceding evaluation window to detect the mean bias condition. We calculate the range of gradient bias and the confidence level for layer adaptation based on the sigma rule. When this condition is satisfied, a new fully connected hidden layer is added by copying the latest hidden layer and stored as the closest hidden layer to the output layer. This is a summary of the proposed controller, which has a control input U comprising of a switching function and the output from a deep neuromorphic controller. Our proposed approach takes four inputs consisting of reference and error horizon in three steps. The output of the network is the control signal for the dedicated axis. We can take a look at the results from Gazebo. The one on the right side is a fixed neural network trained for the circular trajectory tracking, and the plot at the left side is the result of our proposed approach. Since the fixed structure neural network is trained for this particular problem, it performs better than the learning on the fly case. When we define different regimes in a trajectory tracking for a neural network that's trained for the hover, we can see that the performance degrades when the trajectory is a lot faster than the learned case. Our approach handles both cases while adapting to the neural network structure. Similarly, we can see that the control signal is also learned by our approach. We tested the tracking condition with the wind effect cases. The results are summarized in the box plot, and we can see some cases where the layers are added on top of the initial configuration of the neural network. Within the time, the proposed approach decreases the error as compared to the non-adaptive structure. We have also collected data for the interaction case where we had flights close to the ceiling. In the interaction phase, the adaptation converged faster as compared to the other cases, since it starts comparably strong in the beginning and changes in a comparably small range in time. As an addition to the performance results, we have computation time analysis that you can see in our paper. We evaluated our approach in real time. The first case is the tracking under the wind effect. And the second case, interaction with the ceiling. For more results and analysis, please refer our paper. And lessons learned. During the implementation phase, it is observed that the learning rate is one of the significant factors directly affecting system behavior. In general, the layer addition is observed during a sudden disturbance like a wind gust. With the help of the stabilizing conditions, the proposed approach could learn different tasks, variations, and uncertainties in the system dynamics and environmental conditions. There are still rooms for improvement when sudden and frequent changes in a very short period of time are considered. Even if the number of layers is not increasing extremely in the demonstrated flight tests, removing the layers could be investigated with a similar concept. Thank you for listening to this presentation, and we thank our funding bodies, institutions, and organizations. Please share your comments, suggestions, and questions if you have any.